Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome to episode 49 of Let's Build Minecraft. How are you guys? It's been a while. In fact, it's been like, it's been about a week since our last episode. And we've had about one episode in the past 2 weeks. What's up with that? So I got really busy for a little while with school. And I just had to not worry about YouTube. And I didn't, as you can tell. But now I'm back. I'm back. Here I am. I am okay. I'm working on something. Gotta expand a tree. I want this tree right here. I believe. Is this in line? I'm thinking about the bridges. Because long bridges, we can do short bridges on diagonal. But long bridges, let's see, we're on this block. Long bridges are probably going to need to be straight. And we can do a long bridge from there. Yeah, that's going to work. So let's do that. You know, now that I think about it, I want this water closer to this tree. I think I'm going to, instead of moving the tree closer, I think I'm actually going to bring up the water. So while we're at it, let's knock this down. What am I doing, though? I haven't even said. We are going to do a sort of a fishing hut from a tree. I think that's a pretty interesting idea. So the idea is going to be that this hut has a mechanism for lowering boats down into the water. And this isn't the biggest pond or anything, but we can say that there's fish in here, right? Maybe we can expand it. I think that there's more water that way. I'm not entirely sure. I think we might have to expand the actual water to get the water to meet up, though. Ooh, hello, lag. I'm missing the Optifine. It's just not feeling so good running around this jungle without Optifine all the time. But that's beside the point. So anyways, I'm going to, now that these leaves have decayed, I'm going to give these time to decay. And let's put a tree up here. It's probably not going to be, ooh, thank you. It's probably not going to be as tall as that one. That's okay. The varying height is what keeps this interesting. So let's hope that that doesn't vanish beneath us. There we go. That's a big one. That's much bigger than the one beneath it. So we just have to knock these out. And then, do I have jungle wood? I do. Good, good. And then I don't have a way up there. Do I have any vines? I do not. So I'm going to have to get a way up there. And it's raining. And I need building supplies anyway. So I'll be back. I love walking around up here. It's such a cool feeling. It's so dangerous at all times. So this house actually is going to be pretty high up. It may actually be higher up than this one. Eh, we'll have to see. I'd like it to be at a different height. It adds a depth. The bridge is probably going to come from somewhere around here, and we can expand this platform so it's not so crowded. And this building is actually going to be a little bit larger than normal. So, do I have my flight things on? I do not. This tree's actually going to be a little bit larger than normal. How closely can you grow these trees? Because I would like to put another one right about, right around here. Let's clear some of this up. Yeah, this, my tool management is awful. By the way, I've noticed just from all my years of watching other YouTubers, I seem to be the only person who puts their tools on the right side of their toolbar. Am I alone in that? Because I don't know anybody else that does that. And I'm not sure what I start with. I probably just started doing it without thinking about it, and then it grew into a habit, I suppose. Gotta find all of these things for this to decay. There might be some more. Let's pick up these jungle saplings. This is probably all gonna get turned into water, so let's just clear this out just for the sake of having a good clean work area. This tree is probably gonna go. In fact, this tree is going to go. Let me cut this down. I just grew my other tree. It is straight across from the other one. I thought about having it offset, but then I realized I don't want the building to be at a weird angle. That could maybe look cool, but for this, I'm going to have it straight. You know, offset could have worked now that I think about. Got ideas running through my head. I grew probably the wimpiest 2x2, I was going to say 4x4, 2x2 jungle tree that I could have. If this ends up much shorter than that one, then we'll just cap it off where the top of this one is. And then if this one's much higher, then that's cool. That'll look decent. It just adds to it. Not everything needs to be perfect in the jungle. So let's put down some dirt. I'm not sure how much you have to clear leaves or anything for jungle trees to grow. I did have a little bit of trouble getting this one to grow. And I don't know if it's because it's so close to that. I only have 8 bone meal on me, so let's see if I can get it to grow. Let's clear this out. I'm pretty sure that these aren't going to affect it, but at least the ones there. All right. I only got 8. That's awful. Okay, let's stand back, see how high that is. Yeah, that's pretty pitiful. I'm going to manually... Oh, I don't want to manually raise it up, because then I'd have to manually do the leaves. And I don't want to. Man, this one could be 3 high. But if we get one that big again, that'll be enormous. Let's grow another one. And if it's too big, then I guess I'll do the leaves on my own. If it's too big, let's get up here. I'm gonna have to cut this one down. This is the most tedious, kind of boring part of this whole process. I pretty much do off camera most of the time, but I'm showing it to you because there is a little bit of decision making involved, especially when you're planting a new tree. And I'm going to be doing more of that as we go, because I'm going to have my houses in place. I'm going to be able to look and see the gaps between the houses and be like, all right, I could easily fit a tree here. I could fit one there, and kind of go with the flow of the land that way. I'm probably going to need more bone meal, but I'll get back to you guys when I've actually got this tree up so that we can get to building. Laying out this platform right here has got to be my second least favorite part about building these houses. It's not hard. It just takes a little while. My least favorite is these bridges. Like, a bridge this long, I don't even know. The way I've been doing them is I'll make a flat platform, like, 6 blocks below this, and then build up from there. And that's a pain in the butt. That's not so fun. Anyways, so I've got a 2-wide thing here. Let's go ahead and... I want to use jungle wood for this one. Let's put the outline of the building. Why don't we? And I want it to be... Let's see. I want spruce wood for right there. No, not right there. For right there. And we're going to mix up the shape here just a little bit. The backside, probably not so much. I don't know what's all going over here. Most of the city expansion is going to be that direction. This is probably going to be the edge of the town, at least for now. I want to focus on what I think are more important areas to fill out, the higher priority. So let's consider having this part brought in just a little bit. What if we brought it in like that? That's a pretty significant change. And then we get rid of these. there. So this is making room for the boat mechanic, which will lower it to right about here, which will be pretty good when we move this water line back. By the way, if you're wondering what that is, that's just where I get some saplings for some trees that don't normally grow around here. And if you're wondering why that looks so stupid, I don't remember what I was doing. Some kind of testing or something. Get out of here. So, let's put the doorway. Why does this look so... Oh, I was going to say, why does it look so long? But it's because... Let's put a double-wide doorway. This thing's so big. Why not? And not in the middle. We don't want it right in the middle. There's going to be somewhat of a shop, like a bait shop. I have ideas for that. We're going to need some iron. So... Next up, I'm just going to put in the walls, right? Just the way that I normally would. I'll get back to you when I'm done. I've come to a bit of a decision-making point in my building style here. And actually, let's make another decision real quick. And that is the roof line. So the walls of these buildings have been... Let's go out here. I don't have Optifine, so I can't zoom in. But look at this. This wall right here is 4 wide, the edges are 2 blocks high, and the middle parts are 3 blocks high. I am going to do that in the same circle that would exist here. Now, this isn't a perfect circle. Well, none of it's a perfect circle. This isn't a circle in the same sense around the base of this as this is. So I think this is going to have a different style roof on it. Maybe the V, upside down V-shaped, whatever, regular roof. Maybe that would look good here. So the way to get this to flow, I think, will be make the roof as I normally would for this section and then expand over here. But for now, it's nighttime. Let me go to bed. What's the best way to get over there? That looks pretty cool in the fog. Let's see how that looks when I travel through the town. See that in the background? That's going to be so awesome. By the way, I do have plans for, like, maybe next episode we'll work on that. I've got some cool plans. They're going to take a lot of work and a lot of planning. I'm going to see you guys after I do some of that roof work. More boring stuff. These houses aren't that exciting. What's going to be exciting is... the theming of it. So I'll see you then. Small side note, we did hit 150 subs in my... Ooh, oh gosh, I didn't mean to do that. There's a block that didn't disappear and then I got stuck in it. And that glitch is really annoying. I don't know if this fast shovel makes it worse, but it seems to. Anyways, we hit 150 subs while I was on my little break, and assuming that sub decay doesn't take that away, I should still be at it. That'd be embarrassing if I weren't anymore. So, thank you, everybody. I'm just gonna knock this back. I'm gonna look straight up and find out where exactly my boat's gonna come down from. Man, I wish I had my depth strider, but they do not have feather falling on them, and I need my feather falling. So, we're gonna be right around here. Let's take it back just a little bit more. Just back to here. And we're gonna fill it up. Gonna fill it up. I wonder if I can get up there from here. Whoop! And I missed. I got one more to try, and then I gotta go back and get more ender pearls. Yeah, that's not high enough. I wasn't sure if I just... I don't know where I'm going because I'm just going to end back there. I didn't know if I wasn't high enough or if the angle was wrong. I got to get more ender pearls though. I just finished up the roof. I have not looked at it from the outside. That could change things. So there's the desk, sort of. Kind of. I don't know. Maybe I should put... Do I have a stair? I don't have a stair on me, so I'm not going to worry about it right now. Something I wanted to do though is I have a couple cauldrons on me. I want it to look like they've got, like you can sell bait from them, right? And then we'll put water in them. And I only have one bucket, so the other one's out of service, so maybe we can close that one and leave that one open? Or would it make more sense to keep that one closed and leave the empty one open? Let's keep this one open because you can see the water then. Yeah, that's pretty cool. So that's where they're gonna like, you're gonna buy a pass to this boat, right? And it's gonna, we're gonna have a doorway right here. And then this is the section where you would get in the boat, and let's do something to block this off. So it's sort of a barrier. Let's try this. That's the barrier. You can't get over there. You actually can get over there, but don't let anyone know. So that's, you're gonna have to come in here. I'm not sure what we could put here. Some sort of shelving units, I'm sure. There's lots of options. And then let's bring this out a little bit. Sometimes we don't always make these platforms the same size. So let's just bring this up like that. Let's bring this like that just for safety, and it didn't look right without it. And now I do have an idea of what this is gonna look like. Ooh, I don't know how I'm gonna build it. Can you, if you're on top of a fence and you jump, you can place a fence underneath of you, right? I think you can. Yeah. Let's do something along these lines. Something that's holding it. So the idea that I'm going to go with is the boat gets lowered down into it, into the water, and it's got to be supported by something. Maybe I should use a different color. I'm not too worried about it. So there, and then we'll have some sort of roof mechanism holding that up that connects from here, I suppose. I don't have enough. I do have enough. I lied. So if we go, if we just bring this straight out, no, let's bring this up, add some more shape to our roof in the process. So let's do this and just bring it out. Am I making any sense? Does anyone know what I'm doing at all? I'm gonna just bring that out and connect the top of it with this. And then that should, yeah, that's going to meet up here. And then where's this going to meet up? Is that going to meet up here? Hopefully it does not. It does not. Let's bring this one up as well. Like that. And now you actually cannot get, oh, never mind. You can. Not a very effective gate or fence, especially when you do this. Yeah. So then this is going to come over here. And let's wrap this around. I need to get on the other side somehow. Dirt. Dirt is the block of scaffolding. Oh, do I like that? I don't know. Yeah, this is pretty cool. This is cool. I like this enclosed feeling. I don't like, I think I'd rather get rid of that and then do one of those dealios. We could even put logs there. Let's try a few logs, huh? Got a couple of them. Is it already nighttime? Gosh, I feel like I just, can I jump and place? Come on, come on. I'm in the way. I'm in the way of me placing my own block. There we go. It's already nighttime. This game is just flies by so fast. I got rid of my axe. Building with slabs is very annoying. Just gotta try to get it. Try to get it. Yeah, we got it. Let's go sleep. Very effective. All right, from here, I've had a few ideas. By the way, these are going to go all the way down, and I'm not sure. Maybe we put water here. I need water, and then flow down. I've had a few ideas here. I've had the idea of placing actual boats on top of trapdoors, like they're sitting there waiting to be lowered. The idea of Let's try something. I want to take this out and this out. I need stairs. It doesn't matter what it is. Let's try jungle because that's the most common wood in this area, just by a little. I know you guys didn't know that, but I'm here to tell you. Oh gosh, I don't want that. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what I'm doing. That's what I'm not sure of. I don't know how to place blocks. Let's do this, and then we're gonna make it look like this thing has. We gotta use slabs for the bottom, I suppose. So let's grab a couple slabs, and then we're gonna need. That's not a slab. There we go. I don't need those anymore. And then like that, and then the rest is a very simple boat. And it's off the cuff. I made a ton of slabs just because, or trapdoors, just because I keep using them. Oh, nope, not. Let's actually get onto that. And then, that's our boat, right? Do you see, you board in, you close it up, and then it takes you down, and you're very secure in here. I cannot get out unless I do that. Unfortunately, it does not actually lower us. My buddy Spartan Overdrive, go check him out. He has done some things with command blocks where you actually move objects with like command blocks, and you could like make these blocks go down so it would look animated. You couldn't actually sit in it, I don't think. Or maybe you just drop. So I guess you kind of could. But that would be something to think about. That's a very simple boat, but I kind of like it. Our other option would be to like use an actual boat and just set it on a slab or something. Or I'm sure there's other creative ways, but it's super small. And the lore behind this place is that there's going to be a extinct civilization with stone temples, stone ruins down there. Something bad is down there. So, you know, that's why not everyone has one of these boats, because it's dangerous down there. You gotta set stuff up. You gotta pay money to get down there. It's not just a no big deal kind of thing. So let's test out this fence placing thing. What's our best bet gonna be? If you stand on one, I don't know what block I was on. I'm on this block, it looks like. I don't know. Right there. That's not gonna stay like that. But if I... Ooh, you can. Okay. That helps. So I'm just gonna bring this on up. And this is probably gonna look pretty weird. I'm hoping not too weird, though. I'm not sure how I'm gonna close the gap. Right there, and can we just do one of these? Yeah. Cool. That blends in with the floor so much. I kind of wish that I had done... Oh, what is it? This is spruce, right? No, I wish I would have done spruce. That probably would have looked all right. Let's just break this, and down below. Well, that was weird. Did you hear that? That water noise just sounded very strange. I think I have volume kind of high on my end. So then there's a two gap in between. So it's going to be right here. And same thing if I can get up. Lego. I don't know if I'm going to do... Do I want to do the bridge? Oh, I don't want to do the bridge. But if I don't do it, it's never going to get done. I don't know. We'll see. Bring this out, please. I can't. I'm stuck. I'm actually stuck. Hello? There we go. Fence is a little bit glitchy. So let's see how that looks. Does this look like totally retarded? Probably a little bit. But that's okay, right? So let's step back. Let's to open this up a little bit, this whole place, this whole pond, just opening up just a tiny bit, I feel like could really help the feel of it. It's just so small. Yeah, let's get a better angle on it, huh? Swimming is so difficult now. Can't stand not having my depth strider. You know, that actually looks pretty cool. I'm pretty happy with that. So that would just lower it down and you go on your way and fish. That's pretty cool. I had decided to go ahead and do the bridge. I'm just cleaning up my inventory a little bit. And it's time to sleep, it looks like. This looks cool. I wonder what it's going to look like once I have all the trees around it double tall. Because right now it looks like it's on the top of everything. And it's going to look like it's sunk down into the trees once it's done. Something to think about. Something to look forward to. Did I put... No, I got these still. So let's try to get up there. I missed. Yeah, okay. This is actually a good place to be. Now let's be over here. It's a great place. No, I don't like it. Yeah. I actually wanted this tree. Thank you very much. Are you kidding me? There. That is the bridge. And I completely freestyled it, kind of. The most important part is that you have the center in roughly the middle. Now, if it's higher on this side, the center is going to be closer to the left, like that. If it's higher on this side, then it's going to go like that. And it depends on how much slack you have. Like, I have that bridge where it goes straight down and it doesn't go back up. This one goes back up. If I had it go like this, you know what I'm saying? If I had it go down that much, I probably wouldn't have it go like that. That's a ton of slack. And then it would probably look more like that, just thinking about physics. It'd probably hang back further and be really steep if you had any slack on it. So you'd have to have it like that. But this, keep track of this part right here. This doesn't necessarily need to be in the middle between these two buildings, but this section right here should be evenly split between this part, if that makes sense. This part needs to be centered within itself. This part does not need to be centered on the whole thing if they're not even. If these are on the exact same height, then that's a different story. But one of these is higher than the other. So it looks pretty good, especially if you're walking by. You're not going to notice. And it's so long, I can maybe take trapdoors up there. That's so many trapdoors, though. I don't know. I don't like just spamming the bridges with trapdoors. So let's get up there and actually look at it. Are you kidding me? Nope. Oh, gosh. Okay, let's... I'm going through so many ender pearls. I need to get my ender farm done. They're really not that hard. I just haven't done it. So yeah, this is a nice bridge, I feel. And then we can grab some of these and bring this out just to make it feel a little bit more safe. Let's bring out this whole corner, because this is going to be considered sort of a high traffic area. Let's make it a little bit safer for those people, huh? So they're going to come up here. I got to put windows and everything in still. Going to come up here. Going to come in between these doors and they're going to be, "Sir, I'd like to take your boat out. Can I do that?" And he'll say, "It'll cost so much. You go out here. I need a door there too. You bring that down, locked and loaded, you go down, and then you got this whole lake all to yourself." That's pretty dang cool to me. I like that. I like that we found a nice, unique thing to this, a building to make in this area, because that really focuses on the situation that we have. You're not going to find this in our farming town, right? That doesn't make any sense. I mean, a boat rental maybe, but not like this, so I like this. Anyways, guys, that's episode 49. Thanks for watching. Bye!